Hello and welcome to today's video on changing dashboards background. Apple has this tendency to make things a bit colourless. In the case of dashboards, it's a bit sparse, so it's black and greys. What we're going to do is we're going to change this background image in dashboard to something a bit more colourful. It's really not that difficult, it only means you need to change a couple of system files. To change dashboard's background, we first need to find the system file that it belongs to. In Finder, select Go and Go to folder in the menu bar and type in System Library Core Services Doc App Contents Resources. I'll put the link in the YouTube comments. What this does is it opens up the Doc App. This is the application that runs the dock at the bottom. It also runs Dashboard. What we're going to do is we're going to scroll down to Pirelli.png. There's two files, Pirelli.png and Pirelli at 2x.png. The latter is used for retina displays. Copy these to the desktop and stick backup at the end of the name. This is so we can use them as a backup in case we want to ever revert to the original. Now we've backed up the images, we now need to find an image to use. You can use any image you want. I recommend a good high quality image. I'm grabbing one off Interface Lift. So grab it and stick it onto your desktop. It needs to be in PNG format, PNG. So if it's not, which is usually in JPEG, open up in Preview and use a Save As function by holding down Alt when you go to File to save it as a PNG and name it Pirelli. And get rid of that. What we now need to do is duplicate it again by holding down the Alt command and name it Pirelli at 2x. The at 2x is for people using retina displays, but I really can't be bothered to mess around, so I'm just going to name them, duplicate them and rename them. Now we've got these images, we can select them, select all four and drag them back into the Finder window. Finder will ask you to authenticate because you're changing a system file. Simply put in your password and click OK. It'll ask you if you want to replace them, hit replace, replace again, and we're done. Dashboard's background hasn't been changed. The reason for this is it doesn't know that the files have been changed. So what we're going to do is we're going to restart Dock. Now Dock is the application that runs dashboard. Simply open Terminal located in the Applications Utility folder and type kill all dock, dock with a capital D, hit enter. This will restart the dock. You will notice that now Dock's background has changed. It's as simple as that. I quite like this autumn scene. It's a bit more refreshing. Now the dashboard will automatically repeat vertically and horizontally any background you have, so if it's not big enough you will see a tiling effect. Now if you want the complete experience, we can also change Mission Control's background. Currently it's got a very similar background to what dashboard was originally. We can now change this image to replicate what's in dashboard. To change the Mission Control thumbnail, we're going to do something very similar. In fact, we're going to do pretty much exactly the same. In the Finder window we had open before, scroll down to find Mini Pirelli and Mini Pirelli at 2x. Copy these to your desktop so we can create a backup of them by appending backup to the name. Now we're going to take our original image and open it in Preview. We're going to do two things. One, we're going to name it as a PNG file, and the second, we're going to change the size of it. So use the Tools Adjust Size option to change it to something around 400 pixels. This just reduces the size of it and saves us a bit of memory. So use the File Save As Format function again, change the format to PNG and type in mini underscore Pirelli. Hit save. We can close out Preview. So let's duplicate this file and add at 2x at the end of it. This is so Retina displayed Max can you correctly use the image. So we've got our four images. We're now going to copy them back into the Finder window. It'll ask us to authenticate simply because we're changing a system file, so put in your password and hit OK. And when it asks, hit replace. So we've now got our files copied across successfully. Like we did before, we're going to open up Dock. Not open up Dock, we're going to restart Dock using Terminal app. So let's go kill all Dock, hit OK, wait for everything to reopen. You'll now notice when you forefinger swipe up that the dashboard button background has changed. It now matches what was in dashboard originally. Pretty neat. With a couple of customization and tweaks, you can make your Mac as unique as you want. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please subscribe.